Hi friends, how are you? It's Miss Marie, and I wanted to read a book to you today called Pigsty by Mark Teague, because sometimes I find that it's really, really hard to keep my room clean. So I thought we could all read Pigsty together and find out what our friend Wendell does when pigs move into his messy room. Okay, so here we go. Pigsty by Mark Teague. Monday afternoon, Wendell's mother told him to clean his room. "It's turning into a pigsty," she said. Wendell went upstairs. Oh my goodness. And much to his surprise, a large pig was sitting on his bed. Huh. "Pardon me," said Wendell. He shoved some toys into his closet, but the pig didn't seem to mind the mess, and Wendell found that he didn't mind the pig either. Well, he decided he was going to take a break. When Wendell's mom came up to look at his room, the pig was hiding, but the mess was still there. She threw up her hands. "Okay, Wendell," she said, "if you want to live in a pigsty, that is up to you." Wendell could hardly believe his luck. "Now I can live however I want." He didn't seem to worry. He didn't even worry when he came home on Tuesday and he found a second pig in his room. Now he has two pigs. The mess had grown a bit worse, but he was able to jam most of it under his bed. "Pigs are all right," he said, "as long as it's only one or two." In fact, they had a wonderful time. They played Monopoly late each night and left all the pieces lying all over the floor. That looks like fun. They had paper airplane wars and pillow fights. The bed became a trampoline. Wow, they look like they're having a lot of fun, friends. And then, two more pigs show up. Now Wendell has four pigs in his room. The mess just grew and grew. Wow. That night, when Wendell went to bed, the pigs were lying everywhere. They rolled up in his blankets and they hogged his pillows too. Wendell told himself that he didn't mind. But then he found hoof prints on his favorite comic books. And Friday, when he got home from school, he saw that someone had been sitting on his basketball. Friends, look how flat that basketball is. And his baseball cards were chewed up. Oh, no. "That does it," said Wendell. "I've had enough." And he ran downstairs to his mother. "Sorry," she said, "but your room is your responsibility." And she gave Wendell a broom. Wendell, he started to complain. The mess
mess was too huge. But then suddenly he remembered a saying he'd heard that many hooves make light work. Friends, it means if you have plenty people to help, things go pretty easy. He marched upstairs and he organized a cleaning crew. They swept and they scoured, they polished and they scrubbed. Oh, later that afternoon, Wendell inspected the room and he pronounced it clean. Well, in fact, it was a bit too clean from a pig's point of view. So while Wendell inspected the room, the pigs prepared to go home. One of them made a phone call and a farm chop came later to pick them up. They hugged and they grunted and they oinked goodbye. And from that day on, my friends, Wendell kept his room clean, except for those nights when friends came over and came by to play Monopoly. And when we're done with the book, my friends, we say the end. I hope you are doing very well, my friends, and looking at lots of books. I miss you, and we'll see you soon.
Hi guys, I'm gonna teach you how to do Lots of Little Pigs. It is a song about the three little pigs and the wolf. So, I'm gonna teach you some of the hand motions, okay? Can you march? We're gonna have to march with some. We're gonna have to run with some. We're going to have to tiptoe. All right, the other thing that we need to know is how to build. So you're gonna do build, 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 and strong, all right? Because the pigs are gonna build their house big and strong, all right? And then there's two signing words. There's wolf and pig, all right? So wolf, pig, all right? The other move we need to know is how to slam a door. It's gonna go ka-chung, nice and loud. You wanna practice that again? Ka-chung, good job. Okay, all right, so we're gonna get to the song. You're gonna do the words, follow along with me. If I skipped anything, just follow along, okay? All right.
Once upon a time, there were lots of little pigs. And some of them thought they'd build themselves a straw house.
There we go, we're gonna build it.
They built it, big and strong. So the wolves wouldn't get them. And they shut the door.
Ka-chung!
On the next day, some more little pigs decided to build themselves a stick house. So they built it, big and strong. So the wolves wouldn't get them. And they shut the door.
Ka-chung!
On the last day, the rest of the little pigs decided to build themselves a brick house. So they built it, big and strong. So the wolves wouldn't get them. And they shut their big brick door. Ka-chung! In the meantime, the wolves were sleeping in the forest. Stretched a big stretch. And they sniffed a big sniff.
Take a breath.
And they said, I smell pigs. So the wolves marched on over to the straw house.
Their bottoms, and they went running back to the woods, where they cooled off in a lake. And they looked at each other and said, "We didn't want to eat those pigs anyway. Let's go back and have a party."
Okay, so today I'm going to teach you how to draw a simple pig. All you're going to need is a pencil, a pink and black colored pencil, crayon or marker, and some paper. All right, let's get started. First thing we're going to make is a circle. That's going to be the pig's head. Circle. Next, we're going to draw the pig's body. It's going to have a big body. Next, let's draw the legs. Here's one. And the second one, we're going to kind of put on the body, draw the same thing, make it a little longer, and go ahead and erase your lines. Now we're going to draw another leg. And the final leg again on the body, we're going to do the same thing and erase the lines. Let's draw that cute little tail. We're gonna make it curly. Now let's add some ears. One, two. Add some eyes. Now we need to draw that pig snout. Another circle and two little lines and a happy face. And there it is, P-I-G, pig. All right, let's color it. We're gonna color it pink and then outline it in black.
Thank you.
And there's your pig. Thanks for joining me, guys, and Miss Marie. Thanks for reading us that great story. You can always find some more resources, some more books, and some more art at the Summit resource page on the Summit website for parents under Symbaloo or Creative Arts. Have a great day. We'll see you soon.